Grade 9, Structure of the Atom, Part 2, Questions and Answers. Question number 1. What was the discovery of E. Goldstein? Answer. E. Goldstein discovered the canal rays and protons. Question number 2. Write two characteristics of canal rays. Answer. 1. They consist of positively charged particles. 2. The canal rays are deflected by the magnetic fields in a direction opposite to that of the cathode rays. Question number 3. State two main postulates of Thomson's model of an atom. Answer. The main postulates of Thomson's model of an atom are as follows. 1. An atom consists of a positively charged sphere and the electrons are embedded in it. 2. The negative and positive charges are equal in magnitude, so the atom as a whole is electrically neutral. Question number 4. Give one achievement and two limitations of Thomson's model. Answer. Achievement. Thomson's model explains the electrical neutrality of the atom. Its limitations. It failed to explain how the positive and negative charges were arranged in an atom so close to each other. 2. It could not explain the result of the scattering experiment performed by Rutherford. Question number 5. In what way the Thomson proposed atomic model? Answer. Thomson proposed the model of an atom to be similar to a Christmas pudding. The electrons are studded like currants in a positively charged sphere like Christmas pudding, and the mass of the atom was supposed to be uniformly distributed. Question number 6. If an atom contains one electron and one proton, will it carry any charge or not? Answer. No, the atom will not carry any charge. It will be neutral. Neutral atom has equal amount of negative and positive charges which cancel out the effect of each other. Thus, an atom contains one electron and one proton will be a neutral atom. Question number 7. Which scientist concluded that size of nucleus is very small as compared to size of an atom? Answer. Ernest Rutherford. Question number 8. On the basis of Rutherford's model of an atom, which subatomic particle is present in the nucleus of an atom? Answer. On the basis of Rutherford's model of an atom, protons are present in the nucleus of an atom. Question number 9. How do you know that nucleus is very small as compared to the size of an atom? Answer. Rutherford observed that alpha particles were bombarded on a very thin foil, they bounced back. But the number of alpha particles bouncing back got doubled when he doubled the thickness of gold foil. Then he concluded that the area of nucleus is very small in comparison to the total area of the atom. Question number 10. How Rutherford proved that positively charged particles are present in the nucleus of an atom? Answer. Rutherford allowed to bombard positively charged alpha particles over a gold foil and observed that few alpha particles were bounced back. It shows that particles present in the nucleus of an atom are also positively charged, which has repelled the alpha particles. Question number 11. State the three observations made by Rutherford on his alpha particle scattering experiment. Answer. The following observations were made. 1. Most of the fast moving alpha particles passed straight through gold foil. 2. Some of the alpha particles were deflected by the foil by small angles. 3. 1 out of every 12,000 particles appeared rebound. Question number 12. In what way Rutherford proposed atomic model? Answer. Rutherford proposed a model in which electrons revolve around the nucleus in well-defined orbits. There is a positively charged center in an atom called the nucleus. He also proposed that size of the nucleus is very small as compared to the size of the atom, and nearly all the mass of an atom is centered in the nucleus. Question number 13. When alpha particles are bombarded on a gold sheet, only a few of them got deflected, whereas most of them go straight undeflected. Give reasons. Answer. This occurs because volume occupied by the nucleus is very small as compared to that of the atom. That means most of the parts of the atom is empty. Therefore, most of the alpha particles got undeflected. Question number 14. Name the three subatomic particles of an atom. Answer. Electrons, protons, and neutrons. Question number 15. What were the drawbacks of Rutherford's model of an atom? Answer. Rutherford's atomic model failed to explain about the stability of atom. The model also failed to explain the distribution of electrons around the nucleus. Question number 16. What are the postulates of Bohr's model of atom? Answer. The postulates are 1. Only certain special orbits called discrete orbits or energy levels of electrons are allowed inside the atom. 2. While revolving in discrete orbits, the electrons do not radiate energy. 3. The orbits are represented by letters K, L, M, N or the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Question number 17. Which subatomic particle is not present in hydrogen? Answer: neutron. Question number 18. What are neutrons? Answer: neutrons are subatomic particles. They are electrically neutral and are as heavy as protons. They are present in the nucleus of all atoms except hydrogen. A neutron is represented by N. Question number 19. List down three different names given to the path in which electrons revolve around the nucleus. Also explain why are they called so. Answer: the three different names are 1. Discrete orbit. It is called so because electrons revolve in certain distinct path and not just in an orbit, in any orbit. 2. Energy level or energy shell. The energy associated with the different orbits is distinct for each orbit, hence it is called so. 3. Stationary state. Since energy associated with an orbit is fixed, hence the electron revolving in a particular orbit have a stationary energy. So the orbit is also called stationary state. Question number 20. Explain Bohr and Bury rules for distribution of electrons into different shells. Answer: Bohr and Bury rules are as follows. 1. Maximum number of electrons present in a shell is given by the formula 2n raised to 2, where n is shell number. 2. The maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in the outermost orbit is 8. 3. The outermost shell is not occupied with electrons unless the inner shells are completely filled with the electrons. Question number 21. Write electronic distribution in an atom of potassium. Atomic number is 19. Atomic number equals number of protons plus electrons equals 19. Number of electrons equals 19. So distribution of electrons in various shells equals K shell 2, L shell 8, M shell 8, N shell 1, 2, 8, 8, 1. Question number 22. Who discovered neurons? Answer: J. Chadwick. Question number 23. What are valence electrons? Answer: the electrons present in the outermost shell of an atom are known as valence electrons. Question number 24. Define valency. Answer: valency is the combining capacity of the atom of an element with the atoms of the other elements in order to complete its octet. It is determined by the number of valence electrons present in the atom of that element. Question number 25. Why do helium, neon, and argon have a zero valency? Answer: helium, neon and argon have completely filled outermost shell. Helium K shell 2 duplet, neon K shell 2 L shell 8 octet, argon K shell 2 L shell 8 octet. Thus they have stable electronic configuration. They neither lose electrons nor gain electrons. Hence their valency is zero. Question number 26. Find the valency of oxygen and sulfur. Oxygen atomic number is 8. Electronic configuration K shell 2, L shell 6. Therefore the valency equals 8 minus 6, 2. For sulfur, atomic number is 16. Electronic configuration is K shell 2, L shell 8, M shell 6. So the valency is 8 minus 6 equals 2. Question number 27. Three different atoms of oxygen are represented as oxygen lower subscript 8, superscript 16, oxygen subscript 8, superscript 17, oxygen subscript 8, superscript 18. 1. What do the subscripts and superscripts represent? 2. Which factors are responsible for the change in the superscript 16, 17 and 18 though the element is the same? Answer: The subscripts represents the atomic number of the given atoms, while superscripts represents their mass number. 2. Due to the presence of different numbers of neutrons in the given atom of oxygen, their mass number is different from each other because mass number is the sum of number of protons and neutrons. Question number 28. Define atomic number. Answer: atomic number is defined as the number of protons present in a nucleus of an atom. It is represented with the letter Z and written as subscript. Question number 29. Define mass number. Answer: mass number is defined as the sum of numbers of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. It is denoted by A. Question number 30. What are nucleons? Answer: protons and neutrons together called nucleons. Question number 31. Write the atomic number of an element which has mass number 23 and number of neutrons 12 in the nucleus. Answer: atomic number Z equals number of protons in the nucleus. Number of protons equals mass number minus number of neutrons, that is 23 minus 12 equals 11. Therefore, the atomic number is 11. Question number 32. What are isotopes? Answer: atoms of an element having same atomic number but different mass numbers are called isotopes of that element. Example, hydrogen has 3 isotopes, protium, deuterium and tritium. Question number 33. Which isotope of hydrogen contain same number of electrons, protons and neutrons? Answer, deuterium. Number of electrons 1, number of protons 1, and number of neutrons also 1. Question number 34. An atom contains 3 protons, 3 electrons and 4 neutrons. Find the atomic number, mass number and valency. Answer, atomic number equals number of protons equals 3. Mass number is equal number of protons plus number of neutrons, that is 3 plus 4, 7. Electronic configuration of the atom is K shell L, L shell, K shell 2, L shell 1. Hence, its valency is 1. Question number 35. Why do isotopes of an element show similar chemical properties? Answer. Chemical properties depend on the electronic configuration of an atom. Since isotopes of an element have same atomic number and number of electrons or same electronic configuration, hence isotopes of an element show similar chemical properties. Question number 36. What are isobars? Answer. Atoms of different elements with a different atomic number but same mass number are known as isobars. For example, argon and calcium are isobars. Question number 37. Write 2 differences between isotopes and isobars. Isotopes. These are the atoms of the same element having same atomic number but different mass numbers. Isobars. These are the atoms of the different elements having same mass number but different atomic numbers. Isotopes have identical chemical properties and different physical properties. Example, protium, deuterium and tritium. Isobars have different chemical properties and different physical properties because they are the atoms of different elements. Example, argon and calcium. Question number 38. Write the uses of isotopes of cobalt, isotope of uranium and isotope of iodine. Answer. An isotope of cobalt is used in the treatment of cancer. An isotope of uranium is used as fuel in nuclear reactors. An isotope of iodine is used in the treatment of goiter. Question number 39. Do isobars also have identical chemical properties like isotopes? State reason. Answer. No. Isobars do not have identical chemical properties because they have different atomic numbers as well as electronic configuration. Question number 40. Give any three applications of isotopes. Answer: an isotope of cobalt is used in the treatment of cancer. An isotope of uranium is used as a fuel in nuclear reactors. An isotope of iodine is used in the treatment of goiter.